conversion in C. Then how do you convert the data from one data type to another type? Okay, we will discuss in today class. Well, what is type conversion? Okay, hope it is clear. It is very very important concept in C programming. Okay, converting one data type to another data type is the concept of type conversion. What is meaning of the type conversion? To convert the data from one data type to another data type, it is called as what? Type conversion. Here the type conversion can be done in two ways. One is called as the implicit type conversion. Second one is called as what? Explicit type conversion. What is the difference between implicit type conversion and explicit type conversion? The implicit type conversion can done by the what? Compiler itself. Because to convert the data from one data type to another data type by using the what? Compiler itself. User can't be involved in the process of implicit type conversion. Hope it is clear. Then whatever the conversion is there, the conversion can be done by the what? Compiler. That is called as what? Implicit conversion. Sorry to say. Here, you can look at here, it is called as what? Implicit type conversion. Okay, that conversion is done by the compiler. What is called as explicit conversion? What is mean by the explicit type conversion? The conversion is done by the what? Programmer. At that time, the compiler can't be involved in the process of conversion. Who will convert the one data type to another data type? It can be done by the what? User or programmer itself. Hope it is clear. Conversion is done by the compiler. That is called as the what? Implicit type conversion. Then whenever the conversion is done by the programmer, that is called as what? Explicit type conversion. Hope it is clear. Then here, in case of implicit type conversion or explicit type, what is the promotion can be done? What is the hierarchy to convert the data from one data type to another data? Here, this is the hierarchy of the conversion. The short integer to integer, but integer can't be converted into the short integer because it is higher data. Okay, short to the integer, integer to the unsigned integer, then long to the unsigned long, but long to the unsigned long. What is the difference between signed and unlong? Unsigned means which can store the only positive numbers, which can't store the what? Negative numbers. That is the difference between signed means either it can be stored the negative or positive. But in case of unsigned means which can store the only positive numbers. Okay, unsigned long float, the float should be converted into the double should be converted into the long double. So this is the hierarchy of the conversions. But here, the higher promotion value can't be converted to the lower promotion. Because the unsigned int can't be converted to the integer. The unsigned long can't be converted into the long. Because float can't be converted into the unsigned long. This is the hierarchy can be used to convert the data from one data type to another data. Please remember it. How this is the hierarchy should be? You should follow this hierarchy whenever you convert the data from one data type to another data type. Hope it is clear. Then, what implicit type conversion, what explicit type conversion? I will explain you with the help of the example. For example, int x value becomes 10, then float, yeah, character is also there, huh? Your character is also there. Then float y equal to 2.5, then character equal to z equal to then a. Please listen carefully. The x value becomes 10, the y value becomes 2.5, the z value becomes a, because x can be declared as an integer, y can be declared as a float, z can be declared as a character. You should use these hierarchy to convert the data from one data type to another data type. Look at here, for example, x equal to y. Okay. Then x equal to z. If you printf percentile d, yeah, here if I display here, after that
here the statement is here, then printf percentile day, here x should be displayed over here, then x.
Please listen carefully.
Yeah, y is belongs to what? Float delta. X is belongs to what? X is belongs to what? Integer delta. Here, what happens? X equal to y. Y value is 2.5. Whenever it stores the x value, if you display x value, because which can store the only fractional part, which does not store the what? Sorry, which can store the one integral part, it does not store the one fractional part. Okay? Here it will lose, if you done this type of statement in your programming, you can lose the fractional part. Here, what is the expression value will be displayed over here? What is the output will be displayed? Then x value becomes what? Only 2, because y is copied into the variable x. Then in case of here, look at here. Then x equal to z. What is the z value here? Here. What is the value of z? Here. Then z should be, what is the x value here? Integer. How conversion can be done? Here the z value is converted to the integer. Here the float value should be converted to the integer. Because it is implicit. We can't do anything is here. Okay. Here what is the z value here? But what is the x value will be stored here? What is the ASCII value? In case of such cases, the ASCII value should be stored in the integer variable. What is the ASCII value of A? 65. ASCII value of A blank, A becomes 65. Then what is the output? This output is what? 2. This output is what? 65. Okay? Then it is automatic type conversion. It is what is called automatic type conversion. This is called as what? Implicit type conversion. It is also called as what? Automatic type conversion. Here we can't do anything is here. The compiler itself can convert the data from one data type to another. You can try for the more examples. Okay, I have taken a simple example for the implicit type conversion. You have to take the more and more examples. Just you practice more and more, then you get an idea about the implicit type conversion. Hope it is clear. Then I move on to the what? Explicit type conversion. Please listen carefully. It is very, very important in programming concept, in programming languages. Why it is important? Because the conversion is done by the what? Programmer or user. At that time, the compiler can't be involved in the process of conversion. We possibly convert the data from one data type to another data type, that is called as what? Implicit type conversion. Here, what is the syntax for the implicit type conversion is? Syntax is that a data type should be in the parenthesis and then expression. Then followed by the symbol. This is called as what? A variable, whatever variable or expression, whatever it is. The data type should be in the parenthesis, then expression, then it is syntax to convert the data from one data type to another data type by using what? Explicit type conversion. Okay, implicit means it is automatic type conversion is done by the compiler. There is no problem. But if you want to convert the data from one data type to another type, we will use this syntax. Okay. I will explain with the help of the example. For example, int x value is 5, int y value becomes 2. Then int z or x r, then r equal to x by y, then printf percentile d, then r should be displayed. Please listen carefully. XY becomes 5, YY becomes 2, then R can be declared as an integer type, R equal to X by 1. What is the X value? 5. What is the Y value? 2. 5 by 2. Here, it is also integer, it is also integer. The expression value is what? The expression value? The expression value returns integer. In such cases, here R can be float, for example. R can be declared as a what? Double. R float, whatever. Here percent and left can be used over here. Listen carefully. X by y means 5 by 2. What is the expression value? The expression value is 2, our expression value is 2.5. What is the answer you get? Here, it is an integer value, it is an integer value which returns only integer. It does not return the floating point. Because here, what is the expression value is what? It is only 2. Then R equal to 2. Because here if you display the floating, even it is R can be declared as a floating point, but its expression value returns what? 2. But what is the value is 2 only. Here, at the time, the answer you can't get the correct answer. But in such case, what you have to do is we should use explicit type conversion. Okay, then by using this concept, we should able to get the correct answer. Otherwise, in such cases, here any one of the operand is a floating point, then which returns the floating point number. That's why any one of the operand should be converted into the one floating point. Then you will able to get the correct answer. Here float, as per the syntax, float x by y. Here, what is happening for this kind of examples? The x should be converted. Here, it is only for the x, not for the entire expression. If you put the entire expression, what is the output you are going to get? I will tell you. Just wait for a second. Here, the x should be converted into the what? Float. Here, if you convert it to the any one of the operand is. Then the expression value should be returns floating point number. Here what is happening over here? Float x by y. Then x should be converted here. Possibly x should be converted to the float, not the entire expression. Here what is the x value of float? 5.0, then 2. Then 5.0 by 2. Any one of the operand is a floating point number. Then the result will be which returns a floating point number. If both are integer, which returns integer value. If any one of the operand is a floating point, then what is the output is 2.5. What is the output is now 2.5. Or else you convert this one also. Any one of the operand should be converted into the what is called float of y. Here at this time y, pi by 2. 2.0. Here, so 5 is integer, 2.0 is a floating point. What is the answer? 2.5. At this time also, you can get the 2.5 is the answer. For example, this is the way you have to convert the one data type to another data type by using the explicit type conversion. Hope it is clear. Then, for example, if you give like this, many of the programmers will confuse. If you like this, if you use the parenthesis around the expression, then 5, 2, here which returns only what? 2 only, integer values, because here it does not, here float means enter the, it is used for the entire expression. Then if you have put the parenthesis over here, then 5 by 2 which returns 2, then 2 is converted into the float, what is the answer is 2.0. We get the 3 answers. First, it does not be x by y. At that time, it returns 2. Only what is the answer is 2. Then if you write this kind of statement, what is the answer? 2.0. Then if you remove the statement, Here what happened? X should be converted to the integer at the time 5.0 by 2. Then once the answer you got 2.5. This is the correct output of this program. Then X should be converted to the float. Then Y should be 2. Then what it returns? 2.5.
Many of the programmer will can be used in such examples. Hope it is clear. Today I talked about what is type conversion, what is the importance of the type conversion. Hope it is clear. If you get any kind of doubt, please post in the comment box below. Thank you.